Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello, my name is Elfriska Nisa Zahra. I am a student at Telkom University, majoring in system information. And this time, I will present about web system, web-based tenant monitoring and room borrowing application. The presentation of material this time consists of and preliminary introduction, literature review, analysis and design, implementation and conclusion. Now we will start the background of the problem. Bandung Technopark is a company engaged in research and development in the field of information and communication technologies or ICT. Directly under the Ministry of Industry Republik Indonesia, built in collaboration with Telkom Institute of Technology, which aims to grow the world of the ICT and industry. Currently, the system running in BTP is related manually by the company, while the process of borrowing room is still done manually. Prospective tenants come to BTP and register the company or organization to rent room. This makes difficult for related people to collect data, as well as making data reports and room borrowing. Therefore, it is necessary to make and design application that aims to monitor data accurately and in real time. And that the room borrowing system is more organized so that the different parties can manage existing data as reports which will be reported to Ministry of Industry Republik Indonesia. Based on the above background, we can conclude that following problems first, how to facilitate users in collecting data on learn process to make it more organized. Second, how to facilitate data reporting for the Indonesian Ministry of Industry. And the purpose of making this application is first, creating an application to store room loan data in organized manner. Second, provide functionally to create reports for the Ministry of Industry, Republic Indonesia. Next is the problem limitation with this application is that it can only be accessed by organization or company. And then method of work. Here, the implementation of this application uses SDLC waterfall model. The use of this method is compatible with the development of web-based tenant monitoring because the method also provides a clear sequence of application and then develop so that documentation will be systematic and structured. Now, literature review. Nah, here is a history of Bandung Technopark. Starting from a dream of wanting to contribute of development of Indonesia economy through economic growth in the South Bandung area, and an institution that synergies draw of the quadruple helix four main innovation actor is NIDITE, which was established in collaboration between Telkom University and Ministry of Industry Republik Indonesia. And then BTP begin with the establishment of the UPT Telematics and the Telecommunication Design Center as a forum for innovation lecturers, student and the general public, as well as a business incubator as a space for people to learn to do business. The establishment of the CTP is a manifestation of the dream of ITA Telkom academic community that wants to develop develop Technopark as a bridge between educational institution in field of ICT and energy at the industrial world. ITA Telkom as a national higher education institution in the field of information technology and telecommunication has the ability and a number of human research to develop applied research that can be utilized by the reader community. Next is design and modeling tool. Number one, STAR-UML. STAR-UML is a modeling of software that support UML or Unified Modeling Language. Now, STAR-UML can maximize the productivity and quality of software project. Two is YED. YED is a powerful desktop application that can be used to generate high quality diagrams quickly and effectively. YED can create diagrams manually or import external data for analysis. Third is BPMN. BPMN is a graphical notation that describes the logic of the step in a business process. This notation has been specially designed to coordinate the sequence of process and messages flowing between participants in different activities. Next is ERD. Nah, ERD is a entity relationship diagram. Is the most basic modeling in application development. The use of ERD is intended to create relational database modeling. And the last is a use case diagram. Use case diagram are a graphical description of some or all of the actors, use case, and their interaction that introduce a system. Use case diagram do not explain in detail about the use of use cases, but only give a bright description of the relationship between use case actors. Next is analysis and design. Current system overview in the picture explain about the process of borrowing room by the tenant. The tenant comes to BTP and asks the admin for room availability. Then the admin will check the availability of space. If there is, he or she will take notes and the tenant will make payment and fill out the form. If not, then the process is complete. After filling out the form and making the payment, the admin receives the lease agreement form and the payment fee. Then the admin does the printing and submit invoice, and tenant receives invoices and use the room according to schedule. And after the schedule runs out, the process is complete. After the tenant has finished using the room, the tenant makes a monthly report and submits the report to the Indonesian Ministry of Industry. And then the Indonesian Ministry of Industry will receive the report, and the process was complete. Next is implementation. Here is testing. Testing on the web, the tenant monitoring and room borrowing application is carried out to ensure whether the application build has been running according to previous design. In designing and building the web, the main objective is to facilitate tenant in managing all existing data. And in terms of borrowing space, the admin accept room transaction and add space. And then the Indonesian Ministry of Industry will see the report for to test the success of achieving the above objective. A test scenario is carried out. This test scenario functionally that is already running is expected or not without looking at the program code. This test scenario is based on the black box testing method. Conclusion of this final project is this application can store room borrowing data in an organized manner and provide functionally to create reports for the Ministry of Industry of Republik Indonesia. Thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.